Bismillah. Okay, folks, welcome back. We had a bit of a battery failure. Welcome back for the next video. So we can start off where we left off in the previous video. So what we've done is recap quickly on this question. We started at the B. B was being timed by 7, we labeled that the first action. Then it's been added by 10, we labeled that the second action. Then we have to solve by moving the second action first. We started at the last action. Opposite add 10 is?
Minus 10.
Now we left with just time by 7. Copy that down. So now the opposite of time by 7 is?
Divide by 7.
So the final answer is A minus 10 divided by 7. Okay, ladies in the back, have you got that, Samia? Badalba, have you got that? Okay, now, without any further delays, let's move on to the next question. This question is an important question because the item that we're looking to work out is negative. So in this question here, Mr. Saf, P equals 4 minus Q.
Yeah.
The Q that we're looking for is negative. Now, Nazma, do we normally have negative letters?
No.
We need it to be positive. We want to make Q the subject, not minus Q the subject.
Yeah.
So in this particular instance, what we do, normally we leave the thing that we're looking to make the subject, we leave it alone and move everything else. In this case, as an exception, we move the thing that we're trying to work out. So we start at the letter that I want us to make the subject. Because it is a negative letter, we're going to move that instead to the other side. Opposite of minus Q is?
Plus Q.
So we have now P plus Q is equal to 4. And now we're going to start the question for proper now. So you still got to make Q the subject. We start over here. You make Q the subject. It's nice and positive. We're all happy. Q has been added by P. Okay, that's our first action here. So the opposite add P is minus P. So 4 minus P is the answer. Okay. Are you happy with that, Hamza? Good. Okay, let's move over to this question over here. Okay, ladies in the back. We can get that. Okay, now, in this particular question, we want to make K the subject. Okay, now, Utaba, help me on this one, please. K is negative, but before we jump to any conclusions, but we're going to have to multiply by A.
Minus 2.
When we're going to multiply this bracket out to release the K from inside the bracket, we won't need to move the K first because it'll become positive in the process. Now, we have minus 2 brackets 3 minus K equals J. We start at the K. We need to release this 3 minus K from the bracket. It's been held there by what?
Minus 2.
Minus 2 is timesing it. Okay? Right? So we have to multiply the bracket out first to release the K from inside that. So minus 2 times by 3 will give us?
Minus 6.
Minus 2 times by minus k will give us?
Plus 2k.
And as you can see here, the minus k has now become positive, so I'm quite happy with that at the moment. Is equal to j.
So do we divide it by 2?
Okay, now watch what happens now. We have to make k the subject. So let's now identify the actions. Start at k. Umar, what's been done to the k first?
Time by 2.
So this is called the first action. Okay, Ramiz, what's been done next? After it's been timed by 2, it's been?
Plus, added by minus.
It's been minus by 6, yeah?
Yes.
So that's going to be our second action. Now, okay, Ifra, which action do I move first?
Second one.
Okay, so opposite of minus 6 is?
Add 6.
So we've got now 2k is equal to j add 6. Okay, now, okay, Mr. Saf. What's happening over here? We have a time by 2. Now, opposite time by 2 is
divide
by 2. So k is equal to j plus 6, all of it divided by 2, and not just the plus 6 divided by 2. That's very important too, folks.
Sir, if it was to solve it, would you divide the 6 by the 2 to solve it?
To solve it?
Yeah, you would do that one, yeah.
Okay, at the moment, we have now rearranged it to solve, you'd have to put a value in for j.
Okay,
you have to substitute a value in for j and work it out. Okay, let's have a look at our next question over here. So in this question, d is equal to 3e divided by 4, Samia. So we have to make, in this particular question, we have to make e the subject. So the rule says always start, that letter should be start at the e. E is being timed by 3, that is called our
first
action.
Sir.
Yeah.
Why e the subject?
That's what we've been told in the question. You've got to make e the subject. At the moment the equation says, Najma, d equals something. We want to finish with it saying e equals whatever.
Something.
So e has to be made the subject. So that's the first action, and the second action is?
The 4.
The divide by 4. Okay, remember that? So e has been timed by 3 and divided by 4. So divide by 4 is my second action. Okay, so if when we solve it, which action do I move first? Do I move the first action first or the last second action first?
Second.
So we say the opposite of divide by 4 is?
Time
by
4.
So we have 4d is equal to
3e.
Okay, last but not least. Okay, Umar. So e is still being multiplied by 3. So the opposite of time by 3 is? So we can say here now that e is equal to 4d divided by 3. And we're done. And that question. Okay. Okay. For this last question, it's more of a solving question than, but it involves all the techniques of rearranging. Okay, here we go. Last one on this video, and then students are gonna do some questions, and then we'll come back into the next video. We'll go on to the next level of questions. Okay, now, Ifra, in this question here, we have to make what the subject?
X.
So in this question here, we will get a numerical answer. We'll end up solving it. But I just want to go show you the process. Now, okay, Najma, lead me to this one, please. We have x is being, first of all, timed by
2,
which is called the first action. Okay, next, Hamza, the next thing to be done to it has been added by
7,
which will give us the second action. And then, Saf, the last thing that's been done to it has been time by 2, which is called the third action. So in this particular question, we've got 3 steps. First action, second action, third action. This is the crux of these type of questions. You must always start at the letter. You must read or identify, number the actions, and then solve by moving the opposite action. So you'll always get the order right. There'll be no confusion in the examination. So what do we do now? Let's have a look. So the third action is the first one to get moved. Hamza, are you happy with that? Opposite time by 2 is?
Divide by 2.
So 34 divided by 2 will give us? Okay, so we move the third action first. Now we're going to move the, going reverse, or third, second action. Opposite of plus 7 is?
Minus 7. So it's 10.
Okay, so the last bit. And we got time by 2 is the first action. Opposite of time by 2 is?
Divide by 2.
Okay, even this bottom bit.
You finished?
You don't want to worry that though.
Scroll on. Yeah. Okay, lovely. Okay, folks, I hope you can see all those questions. I hope these videos have helped you. Please join us back for the next video. We will go on to the next level of looking at squares and square roots and see how we deal with those and questions that have more than 2 or 3 steps in it. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, folks, just as a quick, these videos, I'm dedicating them to my class in school, 11S6. Okay, folks, make sure you watch it carefully. See you next video.